my name's Dave Fulmart. I represent the performance category, which is the entertainment category. That's all we care about, frankly. What are you doing for us? Every member of your audience is a performance judge. They just want to be entertained. We just get to write the numbers. And the interesting thing about entertainment value is that it's very subjective. Some people don't like insert song type here. Other people really like it when this happens. And, you know, you can't explain that. That's true of any audience. You know, you sat next to somebody and said, oh, that quartet was great. And they said, oh, I wish I'd gone to the restroom. Go figure. That's what we do in the performance category. It's no longer about choreography, which is good, because I'm a terrible dancer. It's about the entire holistic performance, because in-tune singing, entertaining. You know, great dramatic musical lines, entertaining. Stuff you might do physically to show us what you're feeling, entertaining. Stuff you might do accidentally because you're working so hard to sing this song, not entertaining. We don't care. I don't care how long you've been singing, frankly. For the kind of money you folks make, you should just be happy to keep going. But that's sadly true. We are in an amazing organization of volunteers, and we thank you for all your hard work that you brought to the stage today. Because I know personally how much hard work that is, and you had a good performance. I have no idea how it compares to past performances or your expectations. So how does it conform?
For recent times, very similar. We've been living in that mid-B and high B for quite a while. In a few years ago, we scored as high as 879, and when we
give it to me in a percentage, I don't know
that would be in like an A minus,
low 80s.
I think it was that like high 70s.
Okay. High 70s.
That's fine. High B.
Right.
And this is not there. This is mid B-ish. Where are we? Let's see. We were at 66 and 67 on the first song, and 67 and 69 on the second song. I was your friend on both of those.
Thank you.
And that represents a solid performance, perhaps not awe-inspiring yet, but a good performance. And that's really how we left you on the stage there. I thought, you know, nice job, well sung, had good entertainment value. There were some high points to it, some things I think it would be fun to play around with. Do you guys want to, you okay to sing anything?
Sure.
Yes.
Okay, all right, not yet. All right, so you sang Always, which is a great song, and yet, I'd like to know who you are and why you're singing this. You thought I was going to say, to whom are you singing? Back about that. Who are you? And why are you singing this? There's no wrong answers. Well, there might be some. There's no wrong answer to this question. We have a paper on this?
Thanks to this, our president and my right-hand man here, this is something we had a plan about, thinking of Irving Berlin's message.
Yep.
We are the, you know, the marriage part, and then blue skies was the actual thing.
Yeah. No, it fits together nicely. Okay, so yes, we're on the same page here. This song seems to me that it starts or gets, it's very tender, but toward the end it gets a little bit more resolute, a little bit more. You can count on me.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. First, it's you can count on me. I mean it. You can count on me. I need you to hear that. And there seems like there's a little emotional journey there. Now, if that isn't in there, it's just the same song all the way through. So we could put that in there. We could make the first part of it just trying to warm up the subject here for a little while. And by the end, we're like, yeah, count on it. Count on it. Really. So I didn't get much sense of that from you. That's not to say that you didn't have it. It just didn't maybe come across the footlights, of which there weren't any. That's the problem. A couple other little things that would be fun to work on. So when we get to the chorus for the first time, I felt like we were constrained. I didn't see enough organic, I'm really in this. And I don't mean flapping your arms. I mean, a little more body involvement would have been appropriate there. We were a little, I've only got extreme words, locked, frozen. That's not really fair. There just wasn't much feeling of freedom. And that would be a fun thing to have there, more of. We got a little bass feature in here. And like every chorus in the world, except maybe the vocal majority, you don't have as many basses as you'd like. If I could sell you 5 more basses, you'd be getting out your credit card. So, in order to feature the basses, we need the rest of you to knock it off, because it got out of balance. The basses, we hand the ball to the basses, they're going to do all they can do. They're going to do all they can do. And our job, those of us who are not blessed with bass voices, we just got to dial back a little more, because it was out of balance. So you sang over the basses a little.
Do you know what particular part that was?
The bass solo.
Wherever the bass solo is, right before...
Blue skies, smiling...
Oh, that part.
Little section where we hand it to the basses.
Okay.
They tried to take it, but you wouldn't give them acoustic room to take it. So we just need to take a little energy off that, the other 3 parts, so the basses can shine a little bit, because they deserve their moment in the sun, you know?
Yes.
Yeah. Is this a song you're going to keep singing?
Probably, yes.
Okay. Blue skies, same thing?
Yes.
Staying with this? All right. All right. On blue skies, we could actually... And there was a bass solo again that didn't have enough bass in it. And the easy way to fix that, other than recruit 5 more basses, is for the other 3 parts to just dial it down a little bit so we can hear them. There's a little tenor solo that followed that was really good. And toward the end, I wrote, there's some joy breaking out here. Oops, don't let that happen again. No, you should make that your purpose. It'd be really great if more joy would break out at the end. I was a little at the very, very end. Some of you decided maybe you would sing directly to the audience as opposed to through your director. And we need to do either one or the other, but we really can't do both. So there was what I call mixed focal points.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Don't let that happen. That's a simple thing to fix. I know sometimes we get carried away, but you don't want that to happen. So if you wouldn't mind, while we still have a little... Is this the end of your evals?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. Mine too. All right. So he's going to stick his hand in the door and go like this in just a minute, and we'll just go... Right. So would you start all this for me and let me interrupt you a couple times?
Oh, that's the posture.
Dreams?
Dreams will all come true.
Change. It's vocally awesome. I'd like to see a little bit more body involvement going into then, so we get a clearer image that you need to pay attention to this because I'm changing subjects here. Okay, so just a little bit more. I'm going to tell you what to do. I just want you to do a little more, please.
For the edge again?
Unfortunately,
sure, no, that's fine.
We're not far enough in to start in the middle. Yeah. that's all very musical. Really pretty, really pretty. This is the tender part, okay? Now there's a little surprise in here. Then when the springtime is gone, which has got a sort of foreboding feel to it, then will my love, what's gonna happen next?
Linger on.
Well, but I don't know that yet. Okay, so this is the first sort of statement of commitment. And we could use a little bit more show us that.
Okay.
I go around to choruses all over the U.S. saying, you should do something different there, figure it out. Because it not what I tell you to do. The little thing we talked about here just a second ago, that little body change going into this little section, was just enough. That was fine. Okay? So now I need a little more of that. Then will my love linger on? You don't have to worry. When things get tough, I'll be there. That's the first time you're really promising that. You're going to make a little more of that. Okay? Can you start at the semi-minorish part?
Then when the springtime is gone.
This is the eerie part. Okay.
Yeah.
Eerie. Got it.
And springtime
has gone. Better start back.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm sorry. It's okay.
Then when the springtime.
From the edge.
Dreams will all come true, growing old.
You're in tempo, and it's a nice tempo. It's a nice, easy tempo. This is where it'd be great to see a little bit more. I'm not sweating. You did exactly what I knew you'd do. Well, look at that. No. Just freedom. Just a little freedom to express that easy, comfortable tempo a little bit with your body as a whole. This would be a good place to try that, to practice that, okay?
So from I'll Be Loving You?
Yeah.
I'll be loving you always, with a love that's true always, when the things you plan need a helping hand, I will understand.
And then you repeat it. Why?
Emphasis.
Okay.
Reinforcement.
So we've got to make that somehow more special, either softer or more tender or more firm. Something needs to change there, so we just don't think, didn't they just say that word? But add meaning to that second always.
Stephen said that to us the other night.
Yeah, right.
Oh, yeah.
He got out of the speech.
Yeah. One quick question,
sure.
Not to preempt what you're saying there, is we've been working a lot on resets and on the breath and that, so I hope there and in my worst moments, I tell them, please don't be a fence post. So if you had to put a percentage on what we did today, we've been told most recently that we've got 85% of the people all the time, but the judges always say you got to get 100% involved in 100% of the time.
I'm just going to look and see if I wrote a number because I do that. Well, I didn't in this case. Okay, so that would have been about 85%. Which is way better than 65%, which I wrote on some other score sheets. So, no, I think that I feel your engagement, your involvement is pretty consistent, and that's a good thing. Now, could some of you do a better job?
It's not total.
How many of your folks aren't here?
We have somewhere in the quartet.
Sure. No, I know. They're all over.
We had three or four had to go home.
Yeah.
And so we have a couple that were sick at home, so we're a little bit bigger than we were today.
Okay. That's cool. All right. You're doing fine. I would keep doing that, and I'd like you to. Can you pick it up right there? Would you be the second chorus?
I'll be loving you.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll be loving you always. So, do something with that other always, right?
Yeah. Okay. Up to you. You're the singers.
Do something with it.
I'll be loving you always.
Take a little bigger pause before the second always.
Yes. Ooh.
Just to point it a little bit.
That might help. Yeah.
The little bit of difference you made was good. Maybe we can magnify it by just taking a little bigger pause.
When the things you plan?
Between the two always.
No, I'm just saying start.
Yeah. Can you start with when the things you plan?
When the things you plan need a helping hand, I will understand always, always.
Is that okay? That doesn't disrupt anything, does it?
It does.
Yeah, I think it adds a little too long.
Like it.
Now, the danger of taking that pause is taking a rest. You've got to keep engaged. You've got to be in the song. You didn't stop here to get a good breath. You stopped here because this is very, very important, and it's a poignant moment. And that caused me to stop singing for just a half second longer than I would otherwise. Time? Okay, so we're on our own time now. Is that what you're saying?
Okay. The judges that don't have another session are meeting up in the lobby to head over to the restaurant.
Okay. All right. Let's finish the song, if that's okay.
Yeah. And it strikes me that when we take that break, that's a great place for super quiet on that second one, too.
Because now you've made it important without having to sing it louder.
Yes.
Let's sing it.
All right, so when the things you plan.
When the things you plan need a helping hand, I will understand always, always. Be fair always,
voices a big favor by dialing it down 25% so they can be heard. Now, I'm going to start yelling at them in just a minute. Don't worry about it. The handoff to the back to the lead melody is pretty effective. It would be even more effective basses if you didn't try to sound like basses. What if you were just the melody singers? Then we don't have this chasm of sound difference. Mm. Okay, especially since you're kind of coming up in your range there. You don't need to prove anything here. We love you. We love you. And we finally heard you because the rest of the chorus got softer. And so now you can finesse this a little bit so that when it hands off to the leads, we don't know what happened. It's just the melody, for Pete's sake.
Okay. You start right from "This Will Not Be Fair" when you guys have that. This is going into the tag the second time.
So the basses have the melody here. That means you don't.
Days may not be fair. And now I can't find it now. Sorry.
Okay, take it back to when the things you plan.
So be aware that you're still singing that like, here's a bass solo. And then when you do hand it off to the leads, you got to let it go. You're still sort of leading down there, and you just need to change gears and go back into four-part harmony singing, three-part harmony singing, so that is just as smooth as it can be. It was pretty smooth on the stage today. I noted that it was. I just thought we could make it better.
Yes.
And maybe we can. Can we keep going from there and get to the end?
So can we take it? This may not be fair. Always. Here we go, right from the bass solo.
Days not fair. Always.
For some reason, I can't find that.
Days
may
not be fair. Okay, take it from the first, not for just an hour. So that's the first one.
Always, always, days may not be fair.
So, this was when you had some of your other folks here. This is really an effective tag on the stage. It was really good. It was sung really well. You don't have all the singers you had before, and that's affecting things just a little. So don't worry about that. The mood at the end of this, I noted, I thought, this is exactly where we need to be. We just need to feel calm and reassured and loved and cared for, and you got us where you want us to be. That's excellent. Beware barbershopping the end. My friend over here, Art, and another guy in the back row did a little bit of this. Well, that's a barbershop ending, okay? It's always, you can count on me, always. It doesn't need a scoop like that, okay? Because that's not what we do anymore. We're better than that. The lyric of the song tells you if, in fact, you should move in some way at the end. And so beware the standard traditional barbershop moves at the end. Mm. Thank you for doing that, because others do it.
I'll never do it again.
Never do it again.
Do it in this song again.
What a man, Art.
Thank you.
Thank you for your
questions, I can answer them as I go out the door.
Thank you for everything.